Hey guys, and welcome to a little bit of a different video today, actually. Decided I wanted to do a video for this emergency quest that's currently up, Racing Phantom Mother, and kind of show you guys a little bit of a different side of things. Since I've been doing everything on my low-level character on this channel so far, I figured I'd show you guys the character I use for streaming purposes, the character I put the most time into, just to kind of show you guys the opposite end of things, what things kind of look near the end. So this is Chrono Edge. This is my main character that I usually stream on and play on the most. Go over a couple things here with him really quick. He is level 75 Bouncer, level 77 Hunter. I haven't currently finished unlocking the Bouncer unlock since I was a fighter before. I decided to swap over to Bouncer, and I'm having a lot of fun with it. Here's the current equipment. He uses dual blades mostly. The Unballistic is just for increased drop chance, and the jet boots are mainly just a troll, to be honest. It's just so I have jet boots, basically. The rings I'm using are attack advanced and dual blade snatch, or snatched rings, I guess. Is that how it's pronounced? Probably. I don't know. And that's kind of what I'm going with the setup right now. The setup I'm using is a bit controversial, to be honest. I have two trees for my bouncer, which actually you guys remember I mentioned multiple trees in one of my other videos on one of the guides. For this, I'm actually using my full break tree, even going into break crit, and taking, what is it, where did it go, crit field, for extra crit chance as well. Now, I say this is controversial because if you are new to Phantasy Star Online 2, crit is not a normal stat that you actually push into. Crit chance, or when you crit, it's actually only your damage modifier. So you have a damage range for each of your attacks. So say your attack damage range is 1 to 10. If you were to crit, you actually deal an automatic 10 damage. So crit just makes you hit your highest of your chance. Oh wow, someone is cosplaying as Soul Bad Guy. That's pretty cool. A lot of the outfits in this game are pretty fun. Like, my other character has the Ragna outfit from BlazBlue. That guy's got the weapon and outfit and hairstyle for Soul Bad Guy. And headband, it looks like. I think it might be part of the hairstyle, I'm not sure. But anyway, so this is the tree and setup I'm using on this character, the weapons, and the reason is that I've just, in ways I have noticed, higher damage numbers or more overall damage or faster clears with this current build for the parties that I'm in. So crit field isn't only affecting me, it's affecting everyone else. So it's a net gain for any other fighters that are in the group. And it is, anyone will tell you that crit doesn't increase your overall damage. I mean, to be honest, it increases your DPS, but not your top damage possible, since crit only affects the damage range you currently have. When you crit, it makes it so you hit your top damage number, meaning your overall DPS is going to increase. However, it is a possibility that without that crit, you could have reached that number anyway. The chances are just extremely lower. And the reason this build has been working for me is I didn't sacrifice any damage to do it. I could have gone elemental stance. You can stance a bit, but break stance does do more damage on breakable parts. And I have just found, generally, that I've had more success with this build currently. I do have a build that does use break and elemental stance. I've just had more fun with this one, so that's what I'm sticking to right now. Whew, that was a lot to say. So just to go over like the tree that I'm using, that's kind of what I'm using at the moment. We've got about 5 minutes to get to the ship before the emergency quest starts. Just as a heads up, guys, for this emergency quest, I am going to be running rare drop rate boost. I'm also going to be running experience gain, and a tri booster with my max boost and a 4-man party to help increase for my collection files. Collection files are something I'll talk about in a video with you guys at another time. But any other veteran player knows what collection files are and how they work out. This is just, with all these boosts put together for my drop rate, it makes it so one mother run equals 1/3 of the collection file completed, essentially is what it boils down to. I think I have everything I need. Let me double check my inventory. Put eggs away in premium storage. Put these also away in premium storage. Put that away in premium. And this go in premium too. I'm just putting these away in premium storage so I don't have so much in my inventory. Okay, so yeah, those three drop rate boosts I'm planning on using. Alright, so let's go into the camp ship. So I have everything I need. Let's go ahead and head inside. I'm actually doing this mission with some of my teammates. So shout out to my current team, 20XX. Really, really cool guys. They've helped me learn a lot about the game itself. Just kind of randomly found them when they were forming up. Doing an emergency quest. Was invited by our leader, Roy. Yeah. So this emergency quest that we're doing, for if you're new to emergency quests are kind of like the equivalent of event missions or world bosses in other MMOs. They spawn on a timer, or a schedule, so to speak. And that schedule is predetermined of what bosses are going to spawn on what servers. Let me go ahead and pop a shift the drink. And turn on my stances because I always forget them later in the fight. But yeah, those bosses pop on a timer. And right now, Mother is one of the bosses that pops. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to hop into a mission with 8 other people. So the 4 of us plus 8 other people. So a full 12-man party. Kind of like I mentioned in the... I want to say it was the third video? The third guide? Yeah. In the third guide, how there was a 4-man mission. This one's a 12-man. Instead of a single party, this is a multi-party. So it's the 3 parties of 4 people total. Or it can be like individualistic. Basically, it's a 12-man run. So it could be technically... it could actually be 5 parties with 2 people. No, it'd be 5 parties... times 2 is 10. So 6 parties of 2 people each? My mathing right here? 2, 4, 6. Yeah. 6 parties of 2 people each, or it can be, you know, 3 parties of 4 each, you know, however they decide to have it set up. But essentially, we all gather up on the block. In this case, for any vet players know, I'm not on the expert blocks right now. I do have expert blocks unlocked, but not everyone in my team does. So unfortunately, I will be doing this on what we like to call them affectionately as the baby blocks, or the regular extra hard blocks, where people tend to be a little less knowledgeable about the game, a little less knowledgeable about their class, and the fights usually take longer. Basically, this is kind of like the intro to endgame content that you're going to get, and we're going to kind of go into it. So we've got about 2 more minutes to kill until this spawns, because they alert you at 15 minutes in, or 15 minutes till the top of the hour, that the mission itself is going to be spawning. And then the mission starts at the top of the hour itself. What's going to happen basically is, as soon as they pop a notification across the top of the screen, Roy is going to open up the mission terminal, like I showed you guys in the other video, the quest counter terminal. And there'll be a new option available called Emergency Quest at the very top, and he'll select it and select Extra Hard. Now, Emergency Quests do require different level restrictions for different Emergency Quests require different level restrictions for different difficulties. In this situation, Mother requires you have at least 75 of your main, or level 75 for your main class and level 75 for your subclass before you can do this mission on extra hard. Meaning before the level 80 cap, you have to be fully capped out to be able to do this mission. Currently in the game at this time, at the time I'm recording this, it is April 10th, 2017. At this time of the game, the current one of the strongest weapons in the game itself, I would say probably this is the second strongest. Roy just wanted to have his face in the video itself, but the second strongest when you combined S attack and, or when I say S attack, I mean base attack. When you combine base attack alongside of potential, Mother weapons are currently the second strongest. I think the only weapon that beats them outright right now are Gix weapons. There is another weapon currently that is, there's the pop that the emergency quest has started. The other weapon I was mentioning, by the way, that is a notable one, is an aura weapon with a specific potential. Oh, we forgot to grab food and, there we go, stuff for our mag. Mags do require battery life for them to work, so if they are hungry, they won't actually do anything. So we bought 3 Monomates for our mag. Since our mag currently is capped out on its stats. Feeding it anything will actually increase its energy level without messing with its stats. So this mag is a pure striking mag at 200. I mean, I get 200 extra S attack from my mag, which is kind of nice. If you guys want to see my stat spread really quick, what I have at the moment. This is with, the only boost I have is from the Shift the Drink, but I have 3200 S attack, 1500 S defense, and then of course you see the other stats as well. 1100 HP. There are some very interestingly dressed people in this game. This guy actually has a Gix double saber, so he's a fighter. Should be able to, yep, fighter, I can tell that by his symbol. And he has a Gix double saber. Super awesome. They actually have a potential where they increase on their power the longer you don't use a mate item, which is one of the healing items. So the longer you don't need to heal, the stronger that weapon gets to a cap. And the moment you heal, the weapon loses all that strength. Which, ironically enough, would actually be a negative for my current weapon build, for my current character build. Since I use Hunter as my subclass, and as Hunter, one of my skills I have is Automate. So whenever my HP reaches below 50%, I automatically pop a mate item. So that'd actually be a negative for me. But it makes it so I can continue to fight and I don't have to stop to heal myself consistently if I'm taking damage like a baddie. Take a drink of our drink there really quick. Alright, so we're about to start the ride word. So, most people will tell you for ride words, man, these things. The control scheme on them is fucking terrible. But once you get used to them, they're not too bad. So essentially right now what you're trying to do is destroy these... Oh, I can't see them. These four spheres around Mother to make her stop and expose her core so we can deal damage to that. So just by putting your target reticle over the spheres, your Rideroid shoots it. I'm currently playing again with controller, so the left stick controls the height and the side-to-side motion on where my Rideroid is, where the right stick controls where the reticle's at. As you can see, the Rideroid takes a little while for it to move up, down, left, and right, which you can kind of circumvent on controller with pressing the A button. That button makes it so you switch sides really, really quick. Now we've destroyed all four cores, so her center core is open, which we can deal damage to. You press the triangle button, it has the character do a barrel roll spin and deals a bit of physical damage, so it's supposed to be some increased damage. We get two abilities while we're on Rideroid. We get a move where it lets us power boost boost forward to catch up to her when she takes off. You can also use it to close the gap to be able to deal some melee damage to these orbs if you're too far away. Other ability is a missile launch. To be honest, I haven't really mastered how the missile launch actually works out, like what the best method is for using it, if you should use it while you're up close, if you should use it while she's running away, if you should time it so there's nothing in the way to blow the missiles up, you know. All these things are things I'm working on currently, haven't really mastered them just yet. Also, my Rideroid skills aren't the best. Aw, oh, come on. That was a bad shot for missiles. That was really bad, team. Oh, that was terrible. Okay, so this is one of those points where you want to actually have overboost, so using it kind of haphazardly is not really frowned upon, but it does have its consequences. In this situation, I lucked out because the rest of the people that are a part of my MPA, as you will find most people calling it, multi-party area, that are part of this team, they managed to break her four orbs, so she stopped completely in her tracks for the most part. Oh, this is where things get fun. Ugh, I'm gonna go down. I'm probably gonna go down soon. Yep, there we go. So going down is not too big of a deal. It does make it so you do stop attacking, however you revive in 5 seconds, so it's not too bad. And when you revive is kind of random based on where she's located. You basically just follow her in this circle pattern until you deal enough damage to her core to move to her next phase. Now, we're holding off on using this just yet because of trying to weave through here is really difficult. Ugh, I'm dead. Trying to weave through there is really, really difficult when you're boosting. But you notice if we got too far away from Mother, a red exclamation point popped up and we started taking damage immediately. If you get too far away, so if you're too slow, you start taking damage. We're going to keep an eye on it. We're going to shoot that. Hopefully it'll break it. Come on, break, break, break. Got her. Okay, so this should actually finish her off, maybe. Yep, there we go. So we're moving into her next phase. Take another drink of our drink really quick here. Ah, that anime landing, so good. Alright, so right off the bat, I'm gonna pop my buff. I'm also gonna feed my mag really quick. Pop my other buff. And right now, our current goal is to just break these hands. Broken that hand, let's get onto this one. And there should be something coming in our way, so I'm just trying to time what I usually do. She's going, or it's gonna punch the ground, so let's get out of there. Ah, see, this was actually really bad placement for me. Usually I want to have full photon blades whenever she drops into that form. That way I'm not like wasting time gap closing and I can just start attacking her immediately. Nice thing is someone does have weak bullet, meaning hopefully this shouldn't take too long. The two things you want the most in one of these types of parties or these sorts of missions where you're fighting a boss is weak bullet, and you want a Tekker that's going to give you the stronger buffs. Tekkers are support caster types. And these casters have better buffs than just the general shifter ride or D-ban ride, or even the regular shift and D-ban that I have on this character. Tekkers have a better version of that. Even though mine is level 17 and the best it can be, the Tekkers have not only a longer lasting version of it, theirs also increases your stats by more. For example, Tekker D-band increases your HP. As you can see right now, my max HP is 1400, which is pretty nice. Honestly, I feel like it's more than I really need, but... I'm gonna pop Photon Blade Fever. Now, there could be an argument to saving Photon Blade Fever for when the core pops, to make sure you have it on the core itself. But to be honest, in these MPAs, when I'm not in an organized team, I can't always rely on my team to be able to take these hands down in a fast enough fashion to where I'll get enough use out of my Photon Blade Fever on the core. Like, I'll basically be sitting on less activations overall of Photon Blade Fever if I hold it for this specific moment. Like, I got a full use of Photon Blade Fever on the core and on the hands itself, so... Do not. That's one thing you don't want to do, is suffer from too good to use syndrome. Now, I am by no means an expert on my class itself, or playing this game in general. I've had some successes with the way that I've played it so far. So I'm sure there'll be other bouncers that are like, oh my god, you're not switching to elemental stance when you're on the core, and all this other stuff, and I'm like, alright, you know, I'm not perfect, I know that. just get this other hand down. Oh, it died in the air. I didn't even notice. I think one of the most difficult things for me as a player when I was first starting to play this was knowing my ranges. And knowing what's going on Mother's Core, being melee in the middle of that clusterfuck of light, to know when my ability is stopped and when I can cast another ability without just spamming it, since, you know, timing is a very big thing here with abilities for the just attacks. You don't want to just be spamming your ability, you want to actually time it properly for the damage bonuses. Let me pop. These are both up at the same time, which is kind of nice. Like 11k damage on that hand without weak bullet, I feel like is respectable. Come on, come on, come on. There we go. All right, and then we're on the core again. Nice thing is I can just sit back here and just kind of go to town on it. I'd get a little bit extra damage actually being on top of the core, so you don't really want to do exactly what I just did. Since I had one of my abilities up that does damage around me, I wanted to be right on top of the core. Get a little bit extra damage on that. So we just want to look for the opening and get out of there as soon as possible. One trick to that too, a lot of players don't seem to use a lot, is if you start running before you get sucked in, you'll already be in the full speed running animation. So when you're looking for the exit, you'll already be moving the fastest you possibly can be, and it makes it much easier to get out. Actually, wait. Ooh, excuse me. So you can see automate working the way it does at the moment. So I start running before I even get grabbed here, so I'm already in my full running animation. And even if I spun in a circle there for a minute, I still have plenty of time to get out of there before it explodes. Because if you don't make it out of there before it explodes, it one-shots you. I mean, you might be able to survive with a certain amount of HP. I don't know anyone who stacks that much HP, so unless you're a trolley tank build. And I say trolley because, I mean, if you're actually running tank in this game, I don't really think you understand the meaning of the game itself. See, like, this is where I want to be usually whenever I'm attacking, even right on top of her. Because my auto attack is also getting its full value. Also, everyone's getting the value of my crit field without any investment of their own. Ooh, that's close. After a while, you just know the timing for like how close you were to getting out of there. And to be honest, in an expert block, this probably would be over by now. We're not even in the second phase yet, which sucks. See, now, if I didn't have automate on, I'd be dead. Kind of like that guy. And this is why we have moon atomizers. In this situation, I can't see my character at all, so I'm actually just basing it on my gear and my damage numbers that are showing up for me. I thought, okay, so I misjudged the message that popped up. Usually you can tell what phase you're moving into by the message that the operator will say. Usually whenever she says like she's getting weaker or something along those lines, you'll hear it. Hang on one second, guys. Excuse me, sorry about that. Alright, so we're running, getting out of here. Awesome. I'm gonna pop Photon Blade Fever. Oh. Oh. Oh, those are the worst. And that feeling when you have to sneeze, but you can't. Literal worst. Alright, so that's broken. I need a hand. There we go. I think that, yep, core is exposed. Crit field's up. Pop that. Still not enough, though. That's the part that sucks. Oh no, it was. Never mind. Get some free damage in really quick. So, this phase is... Okay, so commonly in this phase, expect a death. If you're new to the game itself, if you're on the non-expert blocks, you're probably going to want to expect to die. Because most of the time, people don't know how to deal with these things properly. Like, I just used wrong PA. Oh, okay, no, we actually managed to get it this time around. But usually, if you don't get all those blocks, she pulses damage based on the number of blocks that get through. And even one or two could almost mean a death for most people. Now, I play this a little bit differently than other classes will. The benefit to playing a bouncer is you have range if you need it, and I use it a lot in here. I'm looking at my cooldowns, they're going to both be up at the same time. Nice thing is this, that little dashing that you see me doing, it's my, or you're going to hear me say this a lot, gear. It's kind of like your weapon special ability, or your weapon type special ability. The dual blade gear allows you to shoot what's called photon blades. These photon blades are kind of like your crazy high single target damage that you can pull off when you have photon blade fever up. It supplements your damage for the most part, but okay, so that's an example of something you don't want to do. You don't want to just pop cooldowns at random, because I actually lost two cooldowns because of that. The orbs exploded right next to me, which knocked me out of the activation animation for my crit field, and then I thought I was safe, and I was going to pop Photon Blade Fever, so I was like, okay, maybe that'll be fine, I'll still get Photon Blade Fever up, and I lost Photon Blade Fever because I wasn't paying attention to the fact that she was about to cast her lasers, so I actually lost both of those cooldowns, because the activations got interrupted. And I could actually be playing this a lot better, but I'm not. I'm just flat out not playing this better at all. Okay, so she's on her last breath. She's about to swap to her next... I believe she's about to swap to her orb phase. Here it goes. Get out of there. So this is the one that usually most people die on. There is a little way of cheating this. If you manage to kill enough orbs to get your photon blast, which I didn't. I'm gonna see if I can iframe part of this. Nope. Funny enough, my build had an extra point left over, and one of my viewers was like, "Well, you've got one point. You know, you're not using it for anything else. Why not put it in Iron Will? It's a 30% chance to survive a hit. I mean, it's not too bad, right? 30% chance to not die." That's worth a point. And I was like, yeah, I doubt it's ever going to save me. Welcome to the first time Iron Will ever save me since I put that point into it. I'm kind of happy I got that on video. And don't make the same mistake I just did, because I wasn't thinking about it at all. I was thinking too much about the video itself. So, the whole point of Running Mother is for a collection file. That collection file, you can increase the drop rate chance. Let me roll this back. Basically, I didn't pop my buffs before Mother was dead, meaning my collection file is applied when Mother dies. Now, let's see here. I think I just got something for my collection file. Yep, double saber, or dual blades. I totally forgot to pop my buffs, which would have increased the progression of my collection file. Awesome, I got my next 13 star to grind into my main weapon. But I forgot. Completely forgot to pop those buffs, so I didn't get the experience buff, I didn't get the drop rate chance buff, I also didn't get the increase to my collection file, which feels kind of bad, but it's not the end of the world. I can tell you it's not the first time that it's happened, but... So, that kind of brings us to the end of Mother. As you can see, I barely got any progress on those collection files at all, which really, really sucks. But that's okay. Not too big of a deal. Yeah, that brings us to the end of Mother. That took much longer than I wanted it to, but that's okay. That's kind of the nature of the beast when you go on non-expert blocks when it comes to these sorts of missions. But yeah, guys, thanks so much for joining me. If you have any suggestions for any other videos, anything else you guys would like explained or you'd like to see, toss it in the comments below. Read all my comments. I'll be more than happy to see that information. If you are new to the channel, I ask that you subscribe. If you like what you saw and you want to see more of it, if you just like the video itself, but you have commitment problems, not much joking, but if you like the video itself or if it helped you out with any information, go ahead and toss a like. And if you want to see more and you happen to be around at the time, I do stream every single day at 7:30 EST currently. That time may change, so always check out my Twitch channel to see the most updated schedule. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for joining me. Later, guys.